detailed joint modelling is required. So when is that going to happen? Who is going to do that? What the output's going to be? Let's have some firm timelines associated with that. And there's reference in the last but one paragraph to the efficiencies of 15-16, which I'm sure we all agree is the most significant year, although 14-15 is also challenging, but 15-16 I think is very significant. So, through a direct reduction of the value of provider contract, I think that probably just needs to be caveated with that, only the demand changes, because clearly we need to have, as Graham has said, improvement in the but I think broadly, I think that the engagement latterly has been very positive. From our perspective, I guess, how far away are we from April 1st? I think it's next week, isn't it? There's a clear objective to start with a 5% reduction. So there's some, I think, depending on the maturity of some of the schemes, some of which I know are running, but as you suggested, there's a pace and a time frame issue here that we need to. From our perspective, we have reflected a better care fund in our planning, but let's be very clear and open. We've also reflected some of the risks associated with the implementation, both in terms of actually we need to make sure that any changes to capacity are reflected on an evidence-based delivery of change, so that we ensure that we're absolutely protecting quality and safety. But I commend the work that you've done, and look forward to working with you, and particularly with the teams, to make sure that some of the schemes that you develop and propose, which are broad, and which I know are more than welcome in lots of areas, be implemented in the best possible way to ensure that we get the best possible outcome.
Thank you.
Anybody else?
Query or comment? General observation is as far as people who work together with fluids and use carbon for gels or sort of binding things, piano cushions or whatever, like cities as a sharing group. And I think really, I'm sorry, I've got as far as page 16 in the appendix, that's the appendix there. On page 16 there's a section on emission avoidance, and when you keep performance indicators, the age of 74 is mentioned several times. What the significance of 74 is, perhaps somebody help. Perhaps there's a sort of a graph that shows what things happen at a certain age, and 74 is a sort of trick one, or working through the figures, 74 is chosen because that seems a good place to learn from.
I think
Sarah
can answer that.
Yeah, I mean, I know it seems arbitrary, but I think the definition of an older person in terms of the performance indicators that are actually measured, and that's actually in the last 74 plus in terms of data and performance monitoring. And it's, they're actually national benchmarks that we are monitoring ourselves against. So that's why you can set that level.
I've got some time left on that one there. Can I ask a second question? On pages, both page 3 in appendix 30 and page 4 in appendix 30, there's the key performance indicator, but the percentage of care packages commenced within 24 hours of initial contact with agency. So I'm close to car, because of getting the pay rates right and the times and everything else. In the sort of care sheet at the bottom, the domiciliary hours bit in the small print on the left hand side of the bottom, talks about new domiciliary care providers must respond to requests for new packages within 1 hour, not for a start time within 24 hours. So there seems to be a little difference in definition there, which I may be misinterpreting or misunderstood, but and perhaps only saying it's just a general thing, this is the more specific thing. But I'll look here just a bit more about the agreement. This is Lux's care agency on that Saturday morning at 12:30. Saying, right, don't worry, we can find somebody and they'll be there and all the rest of it. It's that assurance that it's communicated with, oh, you can't come to staff if I can know that.
I think they can with this now, Bill. Jackie, do you want to comment on that?
I think we appreciate that we haven't had the multiple responses from our providers, Jonathan and Mark, in the
encouraging. No, thank you. Key point for me is that the Vision 2018, so I think it's the same thing. This is a technical to enable putting support into the delivery of the vision without social care, which is a huge issue. So, to a certain extent, that's the focus on those numbers around 32 million, but actually, it's not around 32 million, it's about 700 million or whatever the figure is. Practicality, I think pace and capacity with this ambition 2018, we need to be clear that we can get that and maintain it as we move through that. There is rural support, I think, and we all around the security was being set here. So the scale of transformation is absolutely enormous. Because actually, there hasn't been a huge debate over the last 15 years about doing this sort of thing. Second, Saturday working, so yeah, to be more
touched upon it, that's not universally true. So there is a bit more of a battle to actually get to sit around the table and to understand what it is that's going in. I think that just to follow on Francis, the opportunity on this is fantastic and really should make a difference for all the people that we can serve. But it is about rigour, because what would really help the colleagues at the University of Wellbeing is actually around delivering some of this and doing it properly. And there will be nothing worse than just doing it in a half-hearted way, because that's not going to help any of us do the things that we want to. And I suppose the other thing just around, I suppose it's around emphasis really. So BCF for me is actually just an enabler. So actually it's getting that behind Vision 2020 and doing all of this properly. And it very much it's the start of the journey. We've got the basis on here, we should do something really positive. And it's not about driving it here.
Thank you very much.